Excellencies, I'm privileged to be here with you this morning, and I thank the Spanish Prime Minister, Señor Pedro Sánchez, for inviting me to deliver this statement at this forum. It is rather sad that the pandemic has deprived me and an ardent fan of many decades of Los Blancos of the opportunity of touring the Santiago Bernabéu Stadium as part of my brief visit to Madrid. Hopefully, sooner rather than later, we'll be able to return our lives back to normal once we rid our respective nations of COVID-19. What the pandemic has taught us is that our world is truly interdependent. For a virus that originated in China has engulfed the entire globe. We need to cooperate more, and we need to cooperate smartly. In the midst of all the complexities of the 21st century, our interdependence requires such cooperation. So I applaud Prime Minister Pedro Sánchez for convening Focus Africa 2023, and for the brilliance of the Plan Africa 3 initiative. Excellencies, I'm certain that all of us gathered at this event have become accustomed to news headlines such as at least 43 African migrants drown off Libya, UN agencies say. African migrants drown as boat sails to Spain. At least 140 migrants drown off Senegal coast, UN says. For those of us who come from a continent that is in possession of some 30% of the Earth's remaining mineral resources and some 50% of the world's arable lands, it is disheartening to acknowledge that African youth do not see a future in their respective countries and are willing to cross the Sahara Desert on foot and drown in the Mediterranean Sea in a desperate bid to reach the mirage of a better life in Europe. It is eloquent testimony to the inability of the current structures of African economies, producing and exporting raw materials, importing manufactured goods and services from Europe and elsewhere, to generate the numbers of decent, well-paying jobs that Africa's youth crave. But fortunately, there's now a consensus amongst the current crop of African leaders of the urgent need to remedy the situation and relate with the rest of the world on the base of trade and investment cooperation in value-added activities. As President of the Republic of Ghana, I believe the time has come for Africa, Spain, and indeed the rest of Europe to establish a sustainable strategic partnership based on trade and investment cooperation on the exchange of value-added transactions. It would obviate the resort to aid, which has not achieved its purpose. Hence the mantra of Ghana Beyond Aid, which is the overarching goal of Ghanaian public policy. Indeed, a very important plank of this new strategic partnership between Africa, Spain, and Europe would be the strong support for the African Continental Free Trade Area, AFCFTA, which began trading on 1st January. The AFCFTA will link all the 54 markets of Africa, covering 1.3 billion people, into a single market. It is the world's largest free trade area outside of the World Trade Organization itself. By 2050, it will cover an estimated 2.5 billion people and have over a quarter of the world's working age population. Imagine the investment and business opportunities offered by the infrastructure required to link our markets more effectively. And imagine the business opportunities that this huge market would offer for manufacturing and service firms from Spain and Europe that could establish production facilities in Africa to serve the African markets. And with the enhanced growth that will result from all of these, the market opportunities for exporters from Spain and Europe could be truly amazing. Inasmuch as the pandemic has wreaked havoc on the Ghanaian economy, we've seen a relatively favorable situation with respect to our health outlook, contrary to the fears many had about the impact of the pandemic in Africa. Our active cases in Ghana are declining and now stand at some 2,410 cases. We've recorded some 740 deaths and have since the start of March vaccinated some 500,000 Ghanaians. The goal is to vaccinate 20 million Ghanaians by the end of the year, which would effectively mean the vaccination of the entire adult population of our country. We in Ghana are embarked on a path of accelerated economic development through improved macroeconomic management, improved domestic revenue mobilization, emanating from reforms in public policy revenue and administration, creation of conducive environments for businesses to flourish, tackling corruption and curbing excessive bureaucratic procedures. We are ensuring that all our children have unfettered access to education through our free senior high school policy. We're moving towards attaining universal health coverage for all Ghanaians through the National Health Insurance Scheme. We're processing more and more of our raw materials through our One District, One Factory initiative. We've become a net exporter of food under our program for planting for food and jobs. And we're determined to move Ghana to a situation beyond aid. We have set our sights high. And to our friends in Spain and Europe, I urge you to join us in building a continent of prosperity and societies of equal opportunities for all. Once again, I thank you, Mr. Prime Minister, and I look forward to welcoming you to Ghana very soon. I thank you for your attention.